Hello, my name is Blanca Polo. I am a member of the NCWIT Academic Alliance. I work at Leeward Community College in Pearl City, Hawaii. And today I'm going to share with you a very great tip on how to keep your class engaging and fun while you increase participation from your students. So this is what we're going to do. Okay, in order to get this done, first thing we need to pick a participation token. I got these counting bears from a tub, but you can actually get tennis balls or plush toys, anything that is fun to you and for your class. Second thing we need to do is that we need to keep these tokens relevant. So you can tell the students, 20 tokens equals 20 participation points is, for example, 5% of your grade. That will make students, you know, pay attention and really try to get these tokens. Next thing, it's on you. Number three, be interactive and plan your questions. Think about the stuff you want your students to know and try to sneak some questions around. And of course, as they are answering, you're tossing the bears at them or the tokens, right? When you're walking around, that's number four. Walk around, move, and change your volume. That will keep the students awake. Now, as the students are awake and paying attention, you're tossing the bears, and by the end of class, the students are gonna line up and they are gonna trade their tokens for points. Now, at this point, you may be asking, why would I wanna do that? Why would I wanna wait until the end and have all this tossing and trading? Well, the answer is very simple. If you don't do that, you're going to be interrupting yourself. And that means that all the work that you have done in order to keep the class engaged and fun, you're going to sabotage it by saying, oh, wait a minute, let me go write somebody else and somebody's name. And it's even worse at the beginning of the semester when you don't really know the names of your students yet. So it's better to just give them the tokens, keeps it fun, engaging, and then at the end, just write their names. Okay, so let's give it a try. So we get our participation tokens, okay? And we had made this relevant. It's in the syllabus and the students know that they need to participate in order to get points, okay? We have our questions and we move around. We vary the volume so that the students are awake, okay? So now let's ask some questions. What is the capital of the United States?
D.C.
Okay, what is 2 + 2? Okay, and what is the square root of 874?
29.563.
Okay, nice job. And actually, here, there goes another one because that was a hard question, okay? And so, at the end of class, we are going to collect the tokens. So as the students come in, you pick up the tokens and you write down their names and the number of tokens that they have received. This has to go directly into the gradebook, okay? So that students know at any time how many times they have participated. So I hope that you find this activity or this way of conducting your class fun and relevant, and that your students will love it. I am pretty sure that you're going to be able to engage them more and to promote participation. Good luck.